To access NetApp SaaS Backup, log on to saasbackup.netapp.com. The login screen provides three sign-in options. Sign in using Office 365, Salesforce, or NetApp Single Sign-On. Any of these options can be used to sign on. Either one or both Office 365 and Salesforce service can be configured. First-time users need to sign up for the service. For this demo, we will sign up using Salesforce credentials. You'll be directed to the Salesforce website for authentication. Once authenticated using the System Administrator user, you'll be presented with a sign-up form. Fill out the sign-up form. Click Sign Up to proceed to the SaaS Backup dashboard. You can add the service corresponding to the application you want to protect. In this case, it is Salesforce. Enter the activation code for the service and proceed to choose the storage target options. SaaS Backup for Salesforce provides two storage options. First, storage provided by SaaS Backup, and second, bring your own storage, wherein customers can bring their own backup target storage. SaaS Backup supports Amazon S3 as the backup target for both options. For this demo, we'll select Bring Your Own Storage. You'll need to provide details for the S3 bucket you want to use as storage target and test if you're able to connect to the target S3 bucket. Once you're finished with that step, save the configuration. Now that the service is successfully configured, production or sandbox orgs can be added to it. Let's add a production org to SaaS Backup to protect it. For this process, click Production Instance and click on the plus symbol at the top right corner to add a production instance. Once you press Submit, you'll be redirected to the Salesforce page for authentication. Here, authenticate using System Administrator user credentials for the org you would like to add for backup. Once added, a backup policy named Tier 1 with an RPO of 12 hours and an unlimited retention is automatically assigned to the org, and the org goes into Pending Instance State. An immediate backup is triggered for the production org as soon as it is added. Once the backup gets completed, the org goes into a protected state. You can navigate to the org summary page and get to the backup page for the org by clicking the username at the top of the summary tile. On the backup page, the search bar can be used to search for an object from the list. For the restore, select the object for which the records need to be restored. For this demo, let's select Account and search for the record which needs to be restored. Once the record is selected, click Restore and choose if the restore should overwrite the existing record or create a new record. Also, choose if the record is restored along with its related child records and click Submit. For this demo, let's simulate a data loss in Salesforce org. For this Salesforce org example, the account is Hasta La Vista Corp. Its related contact and opportunity records are deleted. From the SaaS Backup console, the Hasta La Vista Corp. account is selected for restore with relationship. Once the restore job is complete, the record is restored on the Salesforce org, along with its related child records. The job status information helps to identify any issues with the job. On the org backup page, Backup Now can be used to trigger an immediate backup. You can check the scheduled jobs on the job page. Activity logging and job history can be viewed on the reporting page. This information can be used for internal and external audit purposes. SaaS Backup for Salesforce has a very intuitive dashboard which shows the service settings and the instance states for Salesforce orgs. This concludes the NetApp SaaS Backup for Salesforce demonstration.